Hello and greetings from Iceland. As I suspected and mentioned in my last update, I didn't have to wait long for an opportunity to do an update, but it was a location that came as a surprise this time, or Iceland's largest caldera. So I decided to take a break from a longer video I'm working on and talk about this earthquake swarm, since I have also some important news for volcano tourists. So don't skip that bit, but let's start with today's news. And what we have is an earthquake swarm at very little depth in the so-called Torvajökull region. The largest earthquake was 3.2 at 900 meters depth, and that is as shallow as a TikToker by a volcano, getting burned while getting a dream selfie. And what does those earthquakes mean? What occurred to me was intense geothermal activity. This is the largest high temperature area in a country, and that is in a caldera that is about 200 square kilometers, which makes it one of the largest calderas in Iceland. And it is actually quite hard to see the caldera in the landscape. So for a long time, we didn't even know that this was a caldera. And this is also on the highlands, and the earthquakes took place near Landmannalaugar. And it's an area that is best known for the spectacular Rhyolite Mountains and the colors that are the trademarks of the geology in the area, because we don't get the traditional basaltic eruptions there. And there is a connection between this area and Bárðarbunga eruptions. And Bárðarbunga is, according to experts, recharging after the 2014 eruption that woke her up. And it just got some strong earthquakes there yesterday. So if I would have an expert here with me, my first question would be, are those hiccups that Bárðarbunga is suffering from leading to those burps in this geothermal area in the Torvajökull region? And there are actually more things to look at. Like, we just went through some thousands of earthquakes on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And this enormous caldera lies at the intersection of the rift zone, or the transform zone that connects the Eastern Volcanic Zone and Reykjanes. And there are also earthquakes by Langjökull Glacier, and Langjökull is even closer to Reykjanes. So I think it's okay to ask and not sound too stupid, or if the Reykjanes Peninsula is causing some of the unrest that we see now. And we do have other volcanoes around, like the rumbling Katla that's been teasing us all summer. And we don't have to go far to find the volcano Hekla, one of the wild cards, and Hekla's behavior pattern is called the 30-minute warning. And those earthquakes made me think, when was I in Landmannalaugar last time? And the short answer is, it is before I got myself a drone, and don't ask me how I feel about it now. And Askja Volcano is on my priority list when it comes to filming on the highlands this summer, but let's see how goes. I would love to go up to Landmannalaugar, do some hiking, and play around with the drone. But let's go to the Reykjanes Peninsula, and I might have some better news for volcano watchers. If the eruption continues to throttle down like it's been doing recently, like 30-50% last week alone, this will be game over within 2 weeks. Or like one of our professors said in the news today, if you booked a trip to Iceland in September, it's most likely going to be too late. But I try to listen to more than one expert when I can, and a volcanologist said that it was possible that some kind of new activity could increase the power of the eruption and extend the period of activity, but we would need an earthquake for that, rather large, and I think he was also referring to the magma dike that kept on widening after the eruption started. And I have to say, when I look at the earthquake map, that there is still some activity indicating something more than just this crater that has been keeping us busy. There is something more going on under there. So my unscientific guess is going to be, it's 50-50 if this will be alive in September. And it is simply impossible to say. This could just as well be the beginning of something more serious. We won't get lucky all the time, that's for sure. We won't get tourist eruptions all the time. And that goes for the highland volcanoes especially. Systems like Bárðarbunga, Grímsvötn and Katla, they are extremely dangerous. and Hekla can turn extremely nasty if she gets enough time to reload. And as for the Torvajökull area, it might be the biggest wildcard we have. It hasn't erupted there since the 15th century. So I'm leaving links to some of the studies that can be found online if you want to dive deeper. And finishing this with some good news. The Super Zoom camera is already here. But I was busy all this weekend finalizing a video for my town series. So I didn't take it out. Not yet. But the video I was working on has been almost ready since the eruption started. But I felt as I had to get it online before the month is over. Or something for the tourist information department on my channel. And after that upload, tomorrow, Monday, I need to go over some of my plans. Since the volcano messed up my work schedule big time. But in a good way though, I want to say hello to the 6,000 new subscribers I got recently. And let them know that while I'm not working on volcano coverage, I'm often using the time to make more documentary style videos covering not just our volcanic systems in depth, and I have this large series of videos covering each and every town and village in Iceland in the making. And I'm somewhere around episode number 40 now. So it's plenty to come, test footage from the new cameras and lots of other goodies. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island. Iceland.